because you know, to have a group like you who are interested, rather than have the full mosque who are not here, because they will be sitting with their bodies and their minds are not here. So it's not the number which makes you feel that the talk is important or what the brothers are doing here in the mosque is important. It's how much near you are here. So for me, as I said to brother before, I don't care who is sitting in front of you. Either there are two or three or millions of them. Since I'm doing this for Allah, you know, Allah is receiving the talk. So I make it for Allah. And you are here all, inshallah, as well, for Allah. So the time you have this intention, then no matter who are here in the mosque, because the message, inshallah, will go from you, and it will spread. And this is the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's how Islam spreads in the whole world, and it will keep spreading, inshallah, as long as we Muslims are here, at the propagators, at the messengers, and the ambassadors of the Deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Secondly, I want to know from the Dora how long you want me to talk.
Half past eight.
That's fine, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillah, my dear brothers and sisters. As far as I know that we are in the preparation of the month of Ramadan. To start with, to make it just a logical way of thinking, Ramadan is all about fasting. This is the truth, isn't it? This is the truth. Ramadan is all about fasting. And fasting is simply the opposite word of eating. So Ramadan is supposed to be all about fasting and not eating. Today, yesterday, I wasn't going just to buy some normal shopping from the shopping center, from the supermarket. I found families, 5 trays of eggs, 2 lamps, nearly 10 yogurt packets with them. I asked, what is this Ramadan? Ramadan is coming. A list of food, numbers, unlimited list of things that they want to buy for the month of Ramadan. I said, well, Ramadan is all about fasting, not eating. So what is this hysteria in the Ummah, here and there, in the whole world? When Ramadan comes, you want to fill your freezers, your fridges, your stores with food, food and food, eating and eating and eating. It's the logical way of thinking that Ramadan is all about fasting. So what are you doing? They have the whole issue in an opposite way of thinking. This is not why Ramadan is here. Ramadan here for us to stop from eating and to organize the life of intake and input of food. Physically, scientifically, and biologically. While you are fasting, your stomach shrinks. It's true, isn't it? Your stomach shrinks. So the amount of food that you need to eat during the month of Ramadan is normally less than the amount of food that you need to eat outside the month of Ramadan. The size of your stomach becomes small, so the amount of food you need becomes even smaller. So why you need all this big table of unlimited, numberless number of food and sweet and desserts and name it? This is the way that I want to send this message to you, to think logically. Ask them, think logically, what are you doing? This is not logic at all. The way of the month of Ramadan is all about fasting, not eating. And that is the issue that the whole Ummah is, you know, need to wake up to realize that the month of Ramadan is the month of fasting, the month of ibadah. And that's why we need to realize that fact now. And you, when you go home, you need to make people aware that Ramadan is all about fasting, and not about eating. So why this panicking, this hysteria before the month of Ramadan? Shopping center is full of, you know, in a way you can't walk in them. Or like go to any shopping center, it's full of food as if the end of the world is coming. They are piling and packing food in a huge, numberless way that you cannot understand. So it came to my idea when I was shopping today and yesterday to convey this message to you. I don't know if I am, you know, just conveying the right message or not, as if we all have understood the this is the shaitan. This is the shaitan is all the time keeping you thinking about your stomach. This is one issue. The other issue that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made fasting a secret. That secret is between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you have a very important appointment, you do not want to miss it, you keep your alarm clock, especially if it is early in the morning. You keep your alarm clock and bring your mobile number, your clock, the whole, your mother, everybody. You got many alarms to wake you up so you do not miss your appointment. But for fasting, the alarm is not a clock, it's not a mobile. The alarm is here inside you. It's your stomach itself. You are hungry. That's why Prophet Muhammad said, your liver is dry. The liver of my slave, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the Qudusi hadith, كَبِدُهُ جَفَّ. Your liver is dry. Your tongue is dry. Your throat is dry. Your stomach is biting. And you're still fasting. Nobody knows how, nobody feels what you feel. Do you feel like I feel when you are fasting? Everyone feels different. So the alarm is inside you. You can easily cheat. Hide in the toilet or in the kitchen. Have a sip of water. One date. A bit of, chocolate. You can do that, can't you, brother? You can do it. And I believe that many are doing this, especially the children. Many of them, they hide. Nobody knows what he's doing. You can do that. But why don't you do that? That's why Allah is proud among all the angels in heavens. Look to my servants. Look to my slaves. They can cheat. They can eat. They can drink. But why they are not doing that? Fearing me, fearing Allah, that's great. That is the secret which is between you and Allah subhanahu. This is what Allah loves about us and about you and about me. When we fast and we stop ourselves, not for anything, not for anyone, except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِلَّا الصَّوْمَ فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ. That's why he said, Sawm is for me, and I reward for Sawm. Every single deed that you do, you go for every hasana, 10 hasana. That's the standard. That is known for you. Is that right? Every hasana, 10 hasana. Sometimes 70, sometimes 100. But when it comes to Sawm, no. Sawm does not come to the same standards. It has a divine standard. Unlimited standards. Unlimited force that Allah gives you. Why? Because Allah knows that you are sincere. And as much as you are sincere, as much this endless standards, endless force that Allah is giving you will never ever stop at all. And when you are fasting and making qiyam and tahajjud, when you are traveling or giving sadaqah, or reading Quran, or learning the Islam, or learning your deen, just imagine how many faults. Every time you rise up to limits and faults that no one knows. So, the time you make this more sincere, the time you make this between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the time you make all your best to be closer to Allah during the month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love you more and give you more and choose you more. As the Prophet ﷺ said, until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will look at you. Do you know what does it mean, Allah looks at you? That is it. Jahannam will never see your face at all. Why? Because Allah has seen you. Allah has bestowed this rahmah on you. So what else do you want? So why don't you want to be one of those whom Allah will look at them during the month of Ramadan? By making this relation between you and Allah very secret, very sincere, and very open. And you always do everything sincerely for Allah. And do as much as you can, only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the alarm is inside our stomach. Our liver become dry, our tongue become dry, our throat become hard, and sometimes you feel drowsy, sometimes you are tired, sometimes your stomach is biting, but you still want to fast, even though 18 hours of fasting. I have seen my grandchild, 8 years old. His grandmother was begging him to break his fasting. He was dry like that, and he was waiting for iftar to come. You can see his eyes red. You can see he cannot talk because he got a dry mouth. And he is nearly drowsy on the cushion. But he still wants to fast. What is this? This is the deen of Allah. The deen which makes men create humans, real strong human beings. Only this deen which create these people. These people are the people who will lead the humanity to victory, inshallah. Only you who can do that. Only your children and your brothers and sisters of this age, the time they you bring them, you put them, you train them to do so. If they are doing this when they are 8 years old, so imagine what they can do after. If you keep the track, if you keep the track with them, keep them on the right track for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is another issue. The third issue, my dear brothers and sisters, we always talk about Sawm and Siyah, the brothers of Allah reciting from the Quran. Kutiba alaykumu siyamu kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum. So Allah has made Siyam fard. The definition of Siyam is to stop from all the intakes of liquids and solids and gases to your stomach, to your body inside. You cannot have it. You cannot eat or drink or smoke. And as well, no sexual intercourse at all. That is the definition of siyam. But what is more important? What is the essence of siyam? What is more important for us? Siyam or Sawm? Okay. Aren't they the same difference? The same words? No. Sawm is different than Siyam. So what is Siyam? What is Sawm? We know now what is Siyam. Fasting. So what is Sawm? As well in English is fasting. But in Arabic that is a very, very huge difference. So what is Sawm, my dear brothers? Sawm is different. Look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Maryam. إني نذرت للرحمن صوما فلن أكلم اليوم إنسيا. I have pledged to Allah that I'm going to do صوم. So I'm not going to talk to any human being at all. So صوم is related to your tongue. Sawm is related to arahu, kadhib, lying, backbiting. Sawm is spiritual. Sawm is much more wider than siyam. It's easy to do siyam. Even a boy of 8 years old can do siyam. But sawm, maybe huge big men cannot do that. Why? Because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said clearly, man lam yada قول الزور والعمل به فليس لله حاجة في أن يدع طعامه وشرابه. صحيح. For those who cannot stop his tongue from lahu and zur and lying and backbiting and telling names and swear words and yamin ghamus, to make to swear wrongly. If you cannot control your tongue from haram or what kinds of haram, then Allah does not need from you to stop eating and drinking. You can eat, you can drink, because drinking and eating, you know, is not fasting. Fasting, as-sawm, is to control your spirituality, to control your mind, to control your heart, to control your soul, to control your tongue from saying haram, or doing haram, or looking to haram. Your hands not to touch haram. Your eyes not to see haram. Your ears not to see haram. Your nose not to sniff haram. Your legs not to walk towards haram. Your private organs not to do haram. This is sawm. So sawm is all about spiritualities. Mostly lies. Mostly zur. Zur is all type of haram that your tongue can do. All of them, from backbiting, silly names, swear words, lying, you know, shouting. That is all, especially with sisters, mashallah. They have a lot of zur with backbiting and gossiping. They don't stop even during the month of Ramadan. And that is dangerous. Allah is telling you, if you are not going to stop yourself from gossip and zur, you do not need to fast, you do not need to, don't stop yourself from eating. Don't stop yourself from drinking. Why? Because you are not fasting. You are not doing sawm. So the real meaning of sawm is to control your spirituality, to control your tongue, your heart, your soul, your heart from being envious, from being greed, from being aggressive, from being jealous. There are many things that you need to stop your mind. There is nothing worse than a poisonous mind who always think bad, negative about everything around. This is sawm. This is what meant all about sawm. So my dear brothers, من لم يدع قول الزور والعمل به فليس لله حاجة في أن يدع طعامه وشرابه. You do not need to fast. You do not need to stop eating or drinking, because that is not fasting. Fasting is to control your spirituality, to control your inner side, to control your mind, your heart, your soul, yourself from haram, mostly related to your tongue. That's why Maryam said, إني نذرت للرحمن صوما. صوم for her was to stop her mouth, her tongue from saying wrong with any human being at that time. That is sawm. So if you do not know that, you need to rise up to that limit of sawm. That's why Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, كم من قائم ليس له من قيامه إلا التعب والعناء وكم من صائم ليس له من صيامه إلا الجوع والعطش. صحيح. A lot of those who are making tarawih, mashallah, in Ramadan, look to the mosque, all places around is full. People are coming for tarawih. He said, among all those who come for tarawih, nothing is going to be accepted from them at all. They only will have hardness and tiredness, because they are spending all these hours for tarawih. They are not going to gain from their standing the qiyam nothing except being tired and having a hardship. And among all those who are fasting, they are not going to benefit from their fasting nothing except thirst and hunger. Why? Because they do not have the right intentions. They do not have the right intentions. He's only here just because everybody is here. He just come and enjoy. He is there at home fasting because everybody is fasting. He does not know anything about Islam or about the deen except the name. And if he has the chance to stop, he will stop. But because he is following the wave, He is with everybody. In أحسن الناس وأحسن. وإن أساءوا أساء. If they are doing good, I will do it with them. If they are having a disco, I will have a disco with them, no problem. That this is not the deen. So that's why many people who will come for Taraweeh, for Qiyam, they just have, they stand to make themselves tired, having hardship only, and they fast only the stubborn, only hunger and thirst. But what about ajr? What about ajr? Allah knows. How much intention they have, Allah knows. So that's why, my dear brothers and sisters, we need to know the difference between Sawm and Siyam. So Siyam is wider in meaning, and Siyam is part of Sawm. If you have Sawm as a big circle, Siyam comes for your stomach, sexuality, and from as well drinking. That's all. But Sawm is much wider than Siyam. So we need to rise up now to the limit of Sawm, and Siyam will come by default, inshallah. As well, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, we in the month of Ramadan, when we are preparing ourselves for the month of Ramadan, we, as I said before, preparation for the month of Ramadan in daytime, people are keen about, you know, packing and food and drinks. What was the Sahaba doing with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Were they piling food and drinks? Normally for them, what feeds them during the month of Ramadan is the same thing that was feeding them before, nothing more. It's only, but what do? Every one of them, when they cook, they take part, a tray to the mosque. Sadaqah, to the mosque. Either sadaqah as a kafara, for someone who's not fasting, or sadaqah because they are making sadaqah to the mosque. How about the Sahaba? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, were preparing for the month of Ramadan. They used to say, as in the hadith, لا يجرؤ أحد منهم أن يأتي عليه رمضان وفي قلبه شحناء على إخوانه. They do not dare for the month of Ramadan to come, and any of them have got a hardship in his mind, any enmity or any hasad or any envy or any a hardship in his mind, in his heart, towards his brother. So they make taghafur. They go to each other, and everyone asking the other for forgiveness. Have I done anything wrong to you? Have I done anything wrong to you, my dear brother? Please, forgive me if I have done anything towards you, a word, a mistake, if I hurt you, if I forgot to come and visit you. He comes to him and asks for forgiveness. Clears his heart, clears his mind from him. This is the way they used to come and prepare themselves for the month of Ramadan. Not by piling foods and drinks. Look to the Ummah. Brothers, I know now, brothers. Brothers from father and mother. 20 years they have not been told, they are living neighbors to each other. 20 years. They do not talk to each other. They do not enter even their children, their wife. They do not mix whatsoever. It's war if they do that. Ramadan comes and Eid comes and the other Ramadan for 20 Ramadans and Eids. And they are still do not talk to each other, do not forgive each other. What is this? I think unfortunately in our Asian community and Middle Eastern community, we have a lot of this. Unfortunately, true or not, we have a lot of this. So what's the point? Ramadan, to prepare for Ramadan, don't prepare food for your stomach. Prepare it for your heart. Clean your heart. Clean your mind. Clean yourself. Clean your heart. So you shine with light to the brothers and sisters who are around you, who are there with you. Make this place full of light, full of nur, full of love, full of harmony, full of forgiveness, full of guidance, full of deen, full of Quran, full of light, instead of hatred and differences and problems, especially for us in the Asian or Arab community, We have, unfortunately, a lot of problems between the communities, between the persons, between committees, between the imam and the muazzin, between the committee themselves, between the mosque and that mosque, and that area and that area. My God, I've been in problems like this as a judge, where I cannot really want to go. They want me to go and just judge between them for things. Well, you can't. You are an imam. You are an alim. Why do you want me to come and clear your heart? It's you. The problem is in your heart, in your mind. When it comes dunya, when it comes money, when it comes power, it's a different story. Everyone wants to be the boss. Everyone have the highest level. Everyone want to have the biggest amount of money, or the salary, or whatever. Or this one wants to have more students than one. Or he wants to have best room than that one. Or best place. What is this? I have seen many of these things, silly problems. Ramadan comes for us to prepare for it. In our hearts, in our minds, in our souls. Then when it comes to our body, wallahi, 3 pieces of dates and a cup of water, it's enough. When you break for iftar, what do you do? A cup of water, 3 pieces of dates, sometimes 4. Okay, you are big, you are fine, that's fine. Then you are ready, you are done. You can stay till mid of the night, maybe next day. If you do not eat, you are still okay. Why? Because if you are happy, food and drink comes second, comes third sometimes. When you see your mother, your father, your family around you, that is happiness, that is family, that is life, that is Ramadan all about. So you need to create this link and clean all the heart and the minds and whatever between you and your brothers and sisters around you, between neighbors, between families, between mosques, between communities. We need to rise up to the ummah. Wallahi, the ummah needs a lot from us. When we concentrate deeper inside ourselves, making these problems stronger and deeper, we are not doing nothing. We need to rise up to the level of ummah. The ummah needs us all, especially now. Look at the ummah in the whole Muslim world, in Yemen, in Libya, in Egypt, in Iraq, in Syria. Look about the ummah in Pakistan, in Malaysia, in Indonesia, in Mali, in Burma, the Rohingya, in Central Africa. Look to the ummah in China. Muslims are killing them. In Rohingya, they are making them sardines. Sardines! You are seeing them. Wallah, I couldn't even think about what I was seeing. The ummah needs us to be all united and doing the job for Allah. And we are busy making problems, shahna, problems, problems, problems between each other. This is not going to take us nowhere. So Ramadan is one of the stations that Allah have prepared for us. So we can come to Him, come to each other, love each other, care to each other, contain each other, solve each other problems. He give us a chance to meet. Meet in the mosque, meet in Taraweeh, meet in Sahri, meet in Fajr, meet all the times with study circles, Quran recitation, Quran teaching. This is what we need to really work for. Not for more food and more drinks and more problems, which, making this ummah weaker and weaker and weaker. This is an issue as well that we need all to realize for the month of Ramadan, for the preparation for the month of Ramadan, to clear our hearts and our minds and our souls for the month to come, so it can come to its mold, our physical mold and spiritual mold is ready. But when you have many defects in your entity, how do you want the mold of the month of Ramadan to come through you? It will never fit. You will be something, you do not know who you are. You want to fast and you do not. You feel hungry and you do not. You want to pray and you do not want. You want to come to the mosque and you do not want. You feel yourself confused. But when the real essence, the real the month of Ramadan comes to your mold, into your soul, you will find yourself attached to the mosque, attached to your brothers, attached to the ummah, attached to the Quran, attached to the salah, attached to all the spiritualities with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another issue, my dear brothers. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he was talking about the month of Ramadan, the hadith that you mostly, and you feel it from all your imams, all the time, from all the mosques. When Ramadan comes, تغلق أبواب النيران, the gates of Jahannam, what happens to them? Close. How many times you've heard that? Many times. تغلق أبواب النيران وتفتح أبواب الجنان. The gates of Jannah open. And the jinn, the shayateen are locked. Shayateen are chained. وتصفد الشياطين. تغلق أبواب النيران وتفتح أبواب الجنان وتصفد الشياطين. Fine. You agree with the hadith? That's hadith sahih. First. تغلق أبواب النيران. So the gates of Jahannam are locked, closed. Which means that it was opened. Have you realized that before? So normally all the time the gates of Jahannam are لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Jahannam's gates are always open. Do you know if the gates of Jahannam were locked all the time, what's going to happen to it? It will explode. And it will finish the whole galaxy. That's why Jahannam, اشتكت الجن جهنم إلى الرحمن. Jahannam, as in the Sahih Hadith, complained to Ar-Rahman. He complained to Allah, Ya Allah. أكل بعضي بعضي. Myself is eating myself. From the amount of nuclear explosions. أكل بعضي بعضي يا ربي. Ya Allah, my parts are eating my parts from the explosions of the heat. So Ya Allah, give me two breaths. نفسين. Allah said to her, yeah, I'll give you one breath during winter, one breath during summer. And breath means huge nuclear explosions. Not a normal explosions. So the breath which is in summer is the highest heat that the universe can feel. And the breath which is in winter is the highest with ever degree, lower degree that the whole universe can meet. Do you know where is Jahannam? Jahannam is down there in the seventh works, billions and billions of light years. Billions and billions of light years. We still in summer, when the temperature starts to be high in this country, 35 people die. In our country, it's 58. I was in Kuwait, in Dubai, 58. Sometimes 59, sometimes 60 degrees. You put an egg on a car, it's fried. I'm not joking with you. This is truth. That's the truth. We've done that ourselves. Put an egg on a car, it will fry. Put some salt and eat. This is the truth. So even it is that far, billions and billions of light years, and we are still seeing the heat, the worst ever heat that we have in summer is from her breath. Breathing. So what if she wants to really explode in a way that no one knows? So what if the gates of Jahannam were closed all the time? It will burst and destroy the whole universe. Allah will never allow that until the Qiyamah comes. Then Allah knows what's going to happen. Look to the other side to make it easy. So I don't want to horrify you. The other side, وَتُفَتَّحُ أَبْوَابُ الْجِنَانِ. the gates of Jannah is open, which means it is before closed. When you have piece of perfume like amber, you know amber, you put it in a bottle and you close it well. Why? Why do you close? Why you always close bottles of perfume? Why? So the aroma, the essence, the perfume keeps its concentration. You think that Allah does not know that? Simply. So that's why Jannah is always, the gates are closed to keep the essence. حَتَّى تَحْفَظُ الْجَنَّةَ عَبَقَهَا. So it keeps its aroma. It keeps its beauty and essence. For you. For you. Because you want it to be pure and virgin. For you. Even the women of Jannah, not touched by human or jinn. Because Allah knows us human. We like things which is virgin. If you have a bottle of perfume in the shop, you find it a little bit open. Do you take it? Do you buy it? Take it and take another one. Close. No, I don't want this. Why? It, you know, one of the, you know, small, the soil, the paper is, it's not, you don't want to take it. Is it true? And why take this one? Take it there and bring me another one. That is mukhtal, it's no good now. You want virgin. So that's the virginity of the perfume of Jannah. Because their gates are closed. Because Allah wants to keep that for you when you are there. So prepare yourself for Jannah, it's waiting for you. And Hur al-Ain of Jannah are there for you, waiting for you to come, inshallah. Virgins. Not touched by jinn or لَمْ يَطْمِثُنَّ إِنْسٌ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ وَلَا جَانْ. No ins or jinn touches them. For you. So prepare yourself. They are there. بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ for you. But during Ramadan, the gates of Jannah are all opened. So all the humanity, Muslim community in the whole world, we all say that the month of Ramadan is always different than the other months. Is this true or not? Answer me, all of you.
Yes.
True. Why? Because the nur, the essence of Jannah, as much as far as it is under the throne of Allah, the positive energy, the light, is coming to your heart, to your mind, to your soul. It's coming. You breathe it, you feel it. The days of Ramadan, the nights of Ramadan is different. Why? Because the Jannah's gates are open. So just imagine how much positive energy travels all these light years to come to you. And we as a human being on earth feel it. So what if we are there? What if we are there? This, all this distant, and that's, we all agreed that it's different. So what if you are there? What do you think is going to be, inshallah? It's going to be fun, isn't it? It's going to be fun by all means. Brother, I want you to understand this clearly. This is true. The whole Muslims and even the animals, the stones, the trees, they feel the positive of the month of Ramadan. They feel that it's different whatsoever. Why? Because the gates of Jannah is all opened. And the third part is the shaitans are chained. So one will ask me, what about the shaitan inside here? Is he chained as well? No. This one is not chained. This one is supposed to be chained by whom? By whom? By you. Those who are chained are maradatul jinn. Those big shaitans who have control in this one. His masters. His masters who are take haunting him or after him day and night, they are not there. So he is free. And it's your responsibility and your choice, either to control it or not. Some of us will never realize that matter. And he is weaker than you. We, as humans, have 1 degree above jinn. Why? Because Iblis was from jinn. إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ كَانَ مِنَ الْجِنِّ. Iblis was from jinn. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked Iblis to make sujood to who? To Adam. So, Allah ordered him to make sujood, which means Adam, the human being, for Allah, is a degree above jinn. So that means that jinn which is inside you is weaker than you, by all means. So you need to control him. If you are going to feed him with haram, if you are going to feed him with haram food, and haram drink, and haram actions, he will be stronger and stronger. And you need to know that the most important thing that the shaitan physically feed on, because the shaitan, jinn comes from fire. Do you know that or not? So, the most important food for shaitan is fire, is smoke, is shisha or smoking. So that's why he is haunting the whole humanity to smoke and have shisha. Why? Because that's how he feeds. He is feeding. His food, his main food is smoking. His main food is shisha. Look at it. That's why when you have shisha, your mind is floating. When you smoke weed or cannabis or anything, I'm telling you the truth, brother. He is feeding. And when you are under the effect of this drugs by all means, which work with your mind, is his food. That's why it's haunting the whole human beings to be addicted to smoking weed, cannabis, hashisha, or shisha, or any other drugs. So when you are doing this, you are feeding him. You are making him stronger than you. You are giving him more power upon you. The big shaitans are not there. They are not going to whip him after you. No. Now it's your time to whip him. How? Stop him. Fight him. Control him. And there is nothing worse for the shaitan more than tawbah, to repent. Astaghfirullah. Astaghfirullah. To mention the name of Allah. For him, that is Jahannam, that is fire. Burn him. So when you ever mention the name of Allah, the shaitan hide himself in his room. He put a room here in yourself. الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي صُدُورِ. What is صُدُور? Chest. So he is living in your chest, here, in his room. He put that room inside his chest. The time you mention Allah, he goes inside, and he doesn't want to hear it. So the time you are reading Quran, mentioning Allah is there, he can do nothing. He cannot eat, he cannot drink, he cannot whisper, he can do nothing to you. If you don't mention the name of Allah, and you are living in a disco, he comes out, he eat your food, he drink, he force you to have shisha. If you go with a woman, haram, he sleeps with you, and make love to that woman with you. That's why Prophet said to us, if a Muslim man wants to make love to his wife, he must say, Allahumma jannib al-shaytana, jannibna al-shaytana, wa jannib al-shaytana ma razaqtana. Ya Allah, let the shaytan be away from us and away from our children. If you do not do that, the shaytan, even you are a Muslim, will come and make love with you and your wife. You need to know that clearly. And this is the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad. So he eats your food and drink your drinks, sleep in your bed, make love to your wife. You need to know that. You need to mention the name of Allah before you sleep, before you make love to your wife, before you drink. There is, for everything, there is a hadith and there is a dhikr and there is an immunization. Before, in the morning, and after him. And Prophet Muhammad sallam, who is better than me and better than you, he never slept at all without reading all the adhkar, all the immunization. قل أعوذ برب الفلق 3 times. قل أعوذ برب الناس 3 times. And he used to do many, many sayings. Maybe you know in the books of immunization, Hasan al-Muslim. So if you do not do that, these shaitans who are inside you, who is living with you, and he is with you since you born, the time you die. And they live more than we live. Sometimes they live for thousands of years. Like Iblis now is still living because he is Munzar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, have given him the permission to live till the day of judgment. Al-waqt al-ma'loom, to the sa'ah, when the hour comes. Then he died, like everybody died. So if you think that all the shaitans are clear, do not forget that you might be the shaitan yourself. Shayateenul insi wal jinni. Shaitans from humans and from jinn. يوحي بعضهم إلى بعض زخرف القول غرورا. Some people around us, humans, but they are worse than shaitans. Why? Because the shaitan have haunted them all. He live in them, he control them. So they start to be shaitans themselves. The time you look at him, the time you deal with him, the time he speaks, the time he do things, he is worse than a shaitan. So you need to control the shaitan in you. And to control the shaitan, because of the time, and this is the last point. During the month of Ramadan, every one of us, my dear brothers and sisters, you know what are your problems. You do not need me to come and tell you what's wrong with you. Are you one of them who eat haram? Are you one of them who drinks haram? Are you one of them who go on the wrong sites, chatting to the wrong people, watching the wrong things? Are you one of them who got sexual illegal relations? Are you one of them who lies? Are you one of them who is arrogant? Keep backbiting people, lying. Are you one of them? You know your problem is better than myself. So why don't you sit with yourself before the month of Ramadan comes and wake up? Wake up with yourself. Ya Allah, pray, tub, make tawbah. The worst thing to the shaitan is to make tawbah. He comes for you once and you lose your tawbah. Then you say astaghfirullah, then he comes again. And he always say, I've done all my work. Every time I come to him, he makes tawbah, so what shall I do with him? And he leaves you. The worst thing for the shaitan, for a human being, is for him to make tawbah. And when that tawbah is done, so is a good tawbah, complete tawbah, he will never come back to you again. He will leave you alone. So, you know what are your problems. Why don't you sit with yourself before the month of Ramadan and say, Ya Allah, I want to make tawbah. You know, Ya Allah, that I sit all the time on the keyboard, I see all these, you know, wrong sites and talk to the wrong people. I want to make tawbah from this, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, you know that I have wrong sexual relations. I want to make tawbah, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, you know that I steal money and steal things from jobs. There are people that is a disease of them. They are rich, but they still steal a chocolate, chewing gum, small things, but they still cheat. This is haram. You will come with that, carrying that on your back at the day of judgment. So you know yourself very well. Don't you sit with yourself and Allah, maybe Allah will give you tawbah and forgive you. But the month of Ramadan is the month of forgiveness. And the month of Tawbah. And as well, as I said last year, if you remember, I can't believe that it's nearly 1 year when I was with you here before the month of Ramadan, subhanAllah. Ramadan, as I said last year, is the month of Quran. So do not forget your share of the Quran. Recitation, reading, and understanding. That is very important for you and for us. I think that is enough for me today, because he said 8:30, and I tried to keep my, but I wanted to start something else, but I said, if you have any questions, inshallah.